Facts First presents. Sign of life abruptly appears in Death Valley, leaving experts completely confounded. If you're thinking about taking a trip to Death Valley, California, you'd better bring plenty of water and a lot of sunscreen and have a quick exit plan when it gets too hot to handle. The temperatures are oppressive, and yet millions of people still flock there to see what it's all about. People who visit today are a little bit shocked, though. Rather than looking like a wasteland, it looks more like something in a science fiction movie. Signs of life are suddenly appearing there, and one lucky man got pictures that'll blow your mind. Before we show you those photos, help us spread the word about Facts First by clicking that like button. Also, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. In 1848, a group of prospectors took a wrong turn, hoping to find a shortcut, and they found themselves in the middle of a 3.4 million acre dirt, rock, and sand desert. It wasn't long before they were doing everything they could to escape with their lives. While trying to find their way back to civilization, several members of the group died. When they finally found a way out, they muttered, "Goodbye, Death Valley," and that is how it got its name. Regardless of the horrible conditions, people still visit Death Valley. It's a major tourist spot, and in 2016, 1.3 million visitors visited the national park to experience the desolate land and all of its wonders. Many people say they need to experience the climate for themselves. Death Valley holds the record for the highest temperature ever recorded. In 1913, the Furnace Creek region of Death Valley reached a staggering 134 degrees Fahrenheit. No wonder it's called Furnace Creek. It gets so hot there, some tourists will bring frying pans with them so that they can fry an egg right on the ground. It's that hot. In March 2019, tourists visited Death Valley expecting that it would look like the landscape in the Star Wars movies, but they saw something totally different. On March 6, 2019, rain fell in Death Valley. Compared to the rainfall in average climates, it wasn't much. For Death Valley, though, the rainfall seemed like it would be a flood. On average, Death Valley gets only about 0.3 inches of rain per year. This rainfall poured 0.84 inches of rain down on the thirsty plants. The rainfall lasted 48 hours and gave those thirsty plants more rain than they needed. Elliot McGuckin is a physicist and a nature photographer. When it rained in 2015, he headed to Death Valley to get some amazing pictures. He drove to the Badwater Basin area of Death Valley and was shocked when he found a large, motionless puddle. It stretched over the ground like a huge mirror that reflects the rocks in the sky. He was hoping he'd get some photos after this 2019 rainstorm as well to compare to those of 2015. Elliot drove for miles through the desert trying to reach Badwater Basin. On his way, his path was blocked. He made it to Salt Creek, which was once a dried-up lake bed, but when he got there, he discovered a huge, motionless lake, bigger than the one at Badwater Basin. This was something that surpassed his wildest expectations. The sheer size of the lake put what he saw in 2015 to shame. Elliot reached out to Death Valley National Park and let them know about the lake that he came across. They told him that they'd need some aerial photos to determine the actual size of the lake. Elliot got some pretty great pictures, but it did make him wonder what that meant for Death Valley. Dumping a considerable amount of water on the driest place on Earth, that can have some complications. Since the water is not absorbed into the desert, it can cause flooding in the area. According to Todd Larikos of the National Weather Service, it's like pouring water onto concrete. It just sits there. It's called ephemeral lakes. The long-term effects of desert lakes are unknown. This kind of rainfall does say a lot about the future of our climate trends. If it can rain in a place that seldom gets rain, what does that say about climate change? Scientists are worried that this is just the beginning of a more damaging environmental episode. Only time will tell, though, what's in store for Death Valley and its climate. But we do know that the lakes are amazing, and they're something wonderful to see. Subscribe for more!